In this section, we're going to look at quadratic functions and their graphs. So a quadratic function has the form f of x equals ax squared plus bx plus c, where a doesn't equal to 0. Because if a is 0, then this part completely drops, and you end up with bx to the 1 plus c, which is just a linear function. So the a has to be a non-zero number to keep it quadratic. And quadratic basically means you're going to see an x squared involved in that function. Graphs of quadratic functions are parabolas. So whenever you graph anything that has this form or an x squared involved, it's going to open into a curve either up or down. It's either going to have a low point or a high point, and the name of these are the vertex. This is one vertex and that's the other. So this parabola opening up has its vertex and the lowest point. This parabola opening down has its vertex and the highest point. So if it's the highest point, it's got a maximum, and if it's the lowest point, of course, it has a minimum. There's also another feature. It's like a mirror that goes right through the vertex, and that's known as the axis of symmetry. So the axis of symmetry is a vertical line that goes through the vertex of the parabola, so it's going to be x equals some number because it's a vertical line, basically. And that number is always going to be the x-coordinate of the parabola. So whenever you need the equation for the axis of symmetry, all you got to do is really know what the x-coordinate of that parabola is. Let's look at the very basic parabola f of x or y equals x squared. In other words, in this case, a is equal to 1, b is equal to 0, and c is equal to 0 because the bx and the c part are completely missing. So we're going to make an xy chart, or x f of x chart, and plug in some values like negative 3, negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, just to see how it looks like by hand. So I plug in all these x-coordinates into my function as inputs, and the outputs I receive are right here. They happen to be all positive, and they make these ordered pairs that I'm going to go and plot. So at negative 3, I'm up at 9. At negative 2, I'm up at 4, and so forth. So here's my parabola. It's opening up, and it has a minimum at 0, 0. So we can see that the vertex in this parabola occurs at 0, 0. There's also an axis of symmetry or mirror that goes right through the vertex. So x is equal to always the x-coordinate of the vertex, and that's the axis of symmetry. So we got the vertex, we got the axis of symmetry, and we know that it's opening up. This is the most basic parabola we can look at, and we can always graph parabolas by plotting points, but let's go analyze some other forms by looking at a graphing calculator. So we're going to keep it simple, a rather simple parabola, and ask, what is the a in that quadratic form ax squared plus bx plus c? What does the a do? So if I have f of x equals ax squared, in this case my a, remember, was just 1. But what if that's a different number? So the cases we're going to look at is, what if a is greater than 0? In other words, a is positive. What happens if a is less than 0? A is negative. What happens if a is bigger than 1, like a is equal to 2 or a is equal to 3? And also, what happens if a is between 0 and 1, like a is equal to a half or a is equal to a third? Fractions, decimals, numbers that are smaller than 1. What are the things that a does to this very basic parabola that we're looking at here? So here's the analysis. I've put in the original function y equals ax squared, just 1x squared, and notice it's in blue. So the one that's in blue is that very original one we graphed by hand. Once I do it in yellow, it makes it look like it's in black, so let's get rid of it. So the one that's in blue is our original y equals x squared function. Now what happens when I make the a be 2? When I make the a be bigger than 1, notice how the red 2x squared is my function, is really like sort of skinnier, or maybe you can think of it as taller compared to the blue function. Because what I used to have was the ordered pair 1, 1, but now since I'm multiplying the y values by 2, I have the ordered pair 1, 2, and so my graph actually ends up being sort of taller than the original blue one. Now look at the third case, that has a equal to 1 half. So what happens when a is a fraction less than 1 like 0.5 or a half is the a value? That one is graphed in black. And notice the black one, which is y equals a half x squared, is sort of like flatter or wider. You can think of it. So what happens is when the a value is smaller than 1 but still positive, your graph gets kind of flatter or wider. So if I were to do 1/3 x squared, it would be like even more flat. Or 1/5 x squared, even flatter than that. Or if I made the a bigger like 5, it would be even skinnier or taller than the red one I have here. Now the last one we're going to look at is the one that has a negative coefficient. So if it has a negative coefficient, it looks like we've done it in a purple color, and look, it flips. It looks exactly the same shape as the above, but it flipped down. It's as if it's the image of the blue graph, but flipped down. So this is the one that we're looking at, y equals negative x squared. So negative x squared, basically what that does is it flips the graph about the x-axis. So it makes it open downwards as opposed to opening it up. So y equals negative x squared makes it open down. The three things you want to keep in mind is if the a is bigger than 1, it makes it taller. If the a is smaller than 1, it makes it flatter or wider. And if the a is negative, it makes it open down. Now if it was negative 2, it would open down, but it would be kind of skinnier. If it was negative 1/2 x squared, it would open down, but it would be wider. So that's the effect of a. So go back and write these in your notes. A positive opens up for the parabola, a negative, the parabola opens down. If a gets bigger and bigger than 1, it's actually taller compared to the original basic parabola. If a is between 0 and 1, a half, a third, 0.5, 0.66. If it's a fraction between 0 and 1, then it actually makes it wider compared to the original parabola. So make sure you have these in your notes. So we analyzed the a part. The b and the c also have effects on the basic y equals x squared parabola, or f of x equals x squared parabola. What they do is they shift the graph either left or right or up and down. But they're kind of both involved, so we're going to look at some special cases piece by piece and then also go back and put it all together and look at the graph in this version as well. So with the graphing calculator, we're going to analyze a parabola that looks like this, f of x plus or minus a number. So either x squared plus 2, for example, or x squared minus 2. In this case, notice b is equal to 0, and you have a c value, which is the last number here. Or we're also going to look at the case where you have x minus a number, the whole thing squared, and x plus a number, the whole thing squared. In this case, neither b or c is 0, because if I were to multiply it out, I would get this version. So multiplying it out, I would get this quadratic a1, b negative 6, c 9, and similarly, I would get this here. But I'm not going to worry about these versions yet. I'm going to worry about this version and this version, which is already sort of factored a quantity squared. Let's go analyze on the TI and see how these two special forms are going to look like. Notice I'm just leaving a to be 1 because I want it to be the basic parabola, just analyzing how these shifts occur. Okay, let's go analyze these examples right here and right here on the TI calculator. So notice my original function again is the x squared, which is in blue. And for the red one, I've added 2. And notice what has happened. It has gone up 2 steps. Now it goes through the y-intercept of 2. What about this other one? X squared minus, forget the last one, that's not even there. X squared minus 2. When there's a minus 2 involved, that one is in black. It has gone 2 steps down from the origin vertex, and now the y-intercept is negative 2. So going back to our notes, if I add something to the x squared, it shifts it up that many steps. If I subtract something from it, it shifts it down that many steps. So plus 5 would shift it up to 5. Minus 5 would shift the parabola down to negative 5. All right, now let's check these out and see what happens. If I have my original one be y equals x squared, which is the blue guy, and I end up subtracting 3 from inside the parentheses squared, that's in red, notice it has gone to the right 3 units. So subtracting makes it the vertex actually move 3 units to the right. Whereas if inside the parentheses you add 3, now I have the black graph, which notice from the original 0, 0 vertex has actually gone left 3 units. So there was a shift of left and right when I added or subtracted stuff from the inside. So go ahead again, make a note in your notes that subtracting a number from inside the binomial squared shifts it to the right that many steps, and adding a number inside the binomial squared shifts it to the left, the opposite of the way it looks. So here again, adding moves up, subtracting moves down, but inside the parentheses, subtracting moves it to the right and adding moves it to the left, which is sort of counterintuitive. So keep that in mind. So far we know this is a quadratic function that turns into graph and it graphs into a parabola. Some of the simpler forms are with just an a that affects it a certain way, with just a number added or subtracted that affects a certain way, or a number, I called it v in this case, added or subtracted on the inside of the binomial that affects it a certain way. So we will visit these a little bit more later. For right now, let's analyze this basic quadratic function and how we can pull out the most important feature, which is the vertex, out of it. So if I can't, from a graph, see what the vertex looks like over here, it's easy to see the vertex is at negative 3, 0, the vertex is at 0, 0, the vertex is at 3, 0. I can also look at the parabola in this quadratic form and pull out the vertex. The x-coordinate will always be negative b over 2a, and I can get the y-coordinate of the vertex by going and putting it back into the function. So let's find the vertex of this quadratic function and then give a really quick sketch of it. So x is going to be equal to negative b over 2a. So I got my a, b, and c from this quadratic function. I plugged it into negative b over 2a and I got the x-coordinate. Now go find the y-coordinate. When I put negative 1 back into this function, it spits out a negative 4, so the vertex is going to occur at negative 1, negative 4, and because a is equal to 1 and it's positive, the graph is going to open up. So a really quick sketch would be vertex is negative 1, negative 4, and the graph opens up. And notice also the y-intercept happens when you make the x value 0. So the y-intercept is negative 3, and it looks like I have a pretty good accurate graph. And the axis of symmetry is going to be x equals negative 1, because it is always the x-coordinate of the vertex. Let's find the vertex and give a quick sketch of this function. It might be helpful to put it in descending order, so I'll put negative x squared plus 4x, and then I'll put plus 0 to remind myself what the value of c is. So I got my a, b, and c. I have negative b over 2a, so negative 4 over 2 times a. That's negative 4 over negative 2, which is a positive 2. I can pop this back into my function to get the y value of the vertex. So when I put the 2 back in, be careful, this negative is going to wait outside. Everything is going to get squared, and I have negative 4 plus 8 plus 0, which gives me a 4. So the vertex is 2 comma 4, and because a is negative 1, this parabola is going to open down because of the negative. So let's do a quick sketch. So the vertex is 2 comma 4, and it's going to open down and look something like that, and I'm going to make it go through 0, 0 because I know the c is my y-intercept and it's going to go through the y-axis at 0. So all I really worry about is showing the vertex for now and a quick sketch opening down. These details we're going to do in the later section.